Here's my answer. It was Celeste.
Ah, so I'm the suspicious individual now, am I?
Just a little, yeah.
I really do hate this kind of joke.
A joke? I wonder.
So what you are saying, then, is that I specifically chose to work together with Hifumi.
Brace yourselves!
The idea that I would choose to spend any amount of time interacting with him, that I would go within 10 feet of that shit for brains, that lazy, worthless, goddamn idiot! Pardonne-moi.
Just to be clear, there is evidence to support it.
Is that so?
It is. Throughout the investigation, there was certain behavior that was common only to the two of you.
Yeah. What did the two of them do that no one else did?
Considering what we've learned so far, it only further proves that the two of you were working together.
I got it! The behavior they had in common has to do with the suspicious individual in the suit, doesn't it? The only ones who ever actually saw Robo Justice firsthand were Celeste and Hifumi.
Shush, the adults are talking now.
Oh, Cardell.
Sorry. As he said, only Celeste and Hifumi ever laid eyes on the costumed individual. If we accept that Hifumi was one of the culprits, we can't help but suspect what Celeste has said as well.
Are you saying everything they told us was a lie?
After taking Hifumi to the nurse's office, we all began our search for this individual, correct? And not too long after that, do you remember what Celeste said? We headed to the second floor specifically because of what she claimed to have seen.
Limes, actually. I'm out of them now, though.
Next, to draw us all to the physics lab up on the third floor,
she let out a blood-curdling scream.
And technically, Hagakure did not see the costumed individual. Limes, yeah, from a limeade. I got a cherry limeade earlier.
And when we'd all come to see what was wrong, what was it she said? Once she'd done her job of getting us all up to the physics lab, it was time for her partner to get to work.
It was to get us to divide into two groups, so that we would discover both bodies at the same time?
Yep, it was.
In fact, Celeste was precisely the one who proposed that we split up.
Fancy that, huh? I do have to say that despite how out there this case seems, all of the logic is actually sound. There's no moon logic they reach to pull, you know, to reach any conclusions. You just have to pay close attention at other parts of the case, and you can piece things together. It's why I like this game, at least, you know, gameplay and such, a little better than I like, say, the Ace Attorney games, or, you know, other type of visual novels. But no, everything actually pieces together really well.
Well, If Celeste and Hifumi were working together, all those chance events suddenly become connected. And on top of that, that piercing cry of yours early on. That was to signal Hifumi, wasn't it? It was your way of telling him, we're on the third floor, everything's going according to plan. Why else would you let out a scream that could have carried across the sea?
I just realized another strange thing. When we found Hifumi in the nurse's office, who we now know was only pretending to be dead, Celeste, you were the first one to say he'd been murdered. You wanted to make sure we wouldn't have any doubt in our minds.
I don't believe it. Everything, the whole thing was one big act.
Hina, you were with Celeste when Hifumi's body disappeared, right?
Yeah. I was feeling kind of sick, so Celeste took me to the bathroom. Wait! Then that was...
She wasn't worried about you. She just saw a chance to help Hifumi sneak out of the nurse's office.
Each piece isn't much by itself, but start putting them together and the picture gets very ugly indeed. Wouldn't you agree, Celeste?
I have no idea what you mean.
Don't bother trying to deny it. You made one fatal mistake.
Oh, did I?
I didn't even catch it myself when you first said it, but...
Way, way back in the beginning of this case, anybody remember when Lorelei said, I wonder if anyone caught something? This is what we're going to... This is what she was alluding to.
Looking back, I can say that that one little slip-up was your undoing.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about what you said after Hifumi's body disappeared and we returned to the nurse's office.
They're going to replay it now. Let's see if anyone catches the slip.
I remember her saying that too, but... I don't understand what's so strange about it.
Then pay attention. Sakura, Toko, and I were first to discover Taka's body in the equipment room. Then Makoto showed up and told us Hifumi had been killed. So Sakura and I left with Makoto. Once we were in the hall, we ran into Celeste, and the four of us headed to the nurse's office. Now, the entire time we were together, none of us said anything about Taka being dead. Think about it. Celeste's comment doesn't make sense. It was completely out of place.
Yeah, I see what you're talking about. Although I don't really get what it means.
Well, technically she was more referring to, how they had a crazed killer on the loose.
You hear that, Celeste? Everyone's having some trouble understanding. Could you repeat what you said? If you're really not the culprit, you shouldn't have any problem repeating it, right?
Don't worry, we get it right in here. And once again, the Monokuma file number 3 is useless.
All I said was, they must really be enjoying this. Enjoying the sight of us standing around, frightened and confused. They must be positively elated. We are all going to die here. We are going to die, just like those guys died. And that is all I said.
And that's all it takes to finish this. It's obvious, isn't it, what was so strange about Celeste's comment?
Yeah, when she said that, she should have only known about Hifumi's death. So, what is it she said that's so odd?
All I said was, we must really be enjoying this. Enjoying the sight of us standing around, frightened and confused. They must be positively elated. We are all going to die here. We are going to die, just like those...
No, it's wrong. That's right. There's no reason Celeste should have said, just like those guys died. When she said that, none of us had told her Taka was dead.
Exactly. And we didn't run into her until after we were all out in the hall. So there was never any chance for her to have seen his body in the equipment room for herself.
So how did you know, Celeste? How did you know more than one person had been killed? And how did you know they were both guys? Because Kyoko had also disappeared, right? So she could have been dead too.
You all have such vivid imaginations, you know that?
Imaginations?
You claim that I was lying when I told you about the suspicious person I saw. Then what about the picture I took? How do you explain this picture of the costumed villain dragging Hifumi away?
It has to be some kind of setup, right? So let's put the suit on, and then she used the camera's timer to set up the picture.
No.
Have you so quickly forgotten? You are the only one who could have possibly fit into that suit. Plus, I happen to know that this particular camera does not have a timer. In other words, it is an unassailable fact that this is a picture of Hifumi being dragged away.
Is it?
If everything I told you was a lie, how can this picture exist?
Simple. Are we sure that's really a picture of the suspect dragging Hifumi away?
What could you possibly mean by that?
Surely there are other explanations than the one you've offered up.
No, there is no other explanation.
So we gotta turn our thinking around here.
I got it! It's not a picture of the suspect dragging Hifumi away. I would say it's a picture of Hifumi dragging the suspect away.
That's certainly within the realm of possibility. The one being dragged off in that picture isn't Hifumi, but the person in the robot suit. We've simply been led to believe that it's the other way around. And the strange costume might only exist to lead us astray even farther. If you saw someone wearing something like that in this situation, of course you'd notice and be suspicious.
That's what happened! You put me to sleep and made me out to be the bad guy in all this!
Such a thing is utterly impossible. Hifumi was dragging him away? Ridiculous.
Is it? I don't think it's ridiculous at all.
Then shut your mouth and allow me to educate you.
After I passed out. Then you just draped me across Hifumi and had him carry my weight. You tried to make me look like the bad guy.
Like I said, ridiculous. As you can see in the picture, the suspect is standing perfectly upright. If the person inside the suit was unconscious, there's no way they could stand up straight like that.
Then the fortune-telling idiot is the culprit after all!
No way!
So we all caught that, right?
Then you just draped me across and threw me and had him carry my weight. You tried to make me look like the bad guy.
Like I said, ridiculous. As you can see in the picture, the suspect is standing perfectly upright. If the person inside the suit was unconscious, there's no way they could stand up straight.
No, that's wrong. No, even if the person inside the suit were unconscious, they could still stand up like that. Because that robo-justice suit had a certain characteristic.
That's right! They totally made a mistake when they made it, so it couldn't bend at the waist.
I'm not so sure that was a mistake. I think the suit was designed from the beginning to be used the way it was.
Celeste and Hifumi took the suit they'd specially designed and stuffed Hiro into it.
Scoring a few hits, aren't we?
That's how they were able to fake that whole thing. The point of it all was to make us believe whoever was in the suit was to blame.
Well then, I suppose this is checkmate.
Checkmate?
She's a little salty, yeah. And we get the full rotation going on here for her picture.
Don't make me laugh, idiot! What do you mean, checkmate?
Celeste?
Clearly, you want to cram me into your little guilty box. Well, there's one little problem. Have you already forgotten what Hifumi told us as he lay dying? When we asked him who had attacked him, his answer was quite clear, was it not? He said, and I quote, Yasuhiro!
Get on the horse! Yasuhiro Hagakure!
Right! But my name isn't really Yasuhiro! It's actually Taro!
Dude. Don't do that.
Your confusing statements don't make any sense. You're only making things more complicated.
He did say Yasuhiro. But are we sure he was really pointing the finger at Hiro?
What the hell are you talking about? I'll burn you alive!
Kyoko, what do you mean by that?
Think back to how Hifumi used to talk to us.
So yeah, let's pull that tool right back out of the box that we put in there earlier.
How did he refer to each of us?
That's right! Our last names! He called us all by our last names!
In general, yes he did.
Exactly. I know I heard him say Mr. Nayagi more than once, for example. So if Hifumi did mean to say Hiro's name, he would have said his last name, Hagakure.
I'm sure it was just incidental. By chance, he just... his first name.
Indecent?
No, not indecent.
Random chance. Now isn't that a convenient explanation? No, there's no reason to think he would have said the name any different than normal. But he must have run out of energy before he could say any more.
So Hifumi was trying to tell us the last name of whoever killed him?
But the name he said doesn't apply to anyone here.
Well, no. Hold on. There's one person it could apply to. And that's Celeste. She never actually told us what her real name is.
Yeah, this goes way back, doesn't it?
What did you just say? To think you'd take your false accusation so far, I don't know whether to laugh or spit! Come on! Enough with your idiotic blather! Yasuhiro is a loser's name! Do I look like a loser to you? Well, do I? What? I think I've earned the right to be a little on edge.
Okay, then fill us in. What's your real name?
Make sure your ear holes are wide open and listen up! My real name is Celestia Ludenberg. Could you please stop making me repeat myself over and over again?
Well, we can prove it. We can prove what her name is.
Ifumi was trying to tell us something. He wanted us to know the killer's last name, Yasuhiro.
If there's one person here who might have that last name...
It would have to be you, Celeste. You haven't told anyone what your real name is.
How many times do I have to tell you? My name is... Celestia Ludenberg, goddammit!
How long do you plan to go on pretending?
I'm not pretending. It's the truth. And since you have no way to contradict me...
No, it's wrong! That's it! The handbook!
What?!
Anytime you turn your handbook on, it shows the owner's name when it boots up, right? Monokuma told us all about it before. So all we have to do is check her handbook, and that'll clear up everything. That's how we can find out Celeste's real name.
That's an invasion of privacy! I refuse to cooperate!
I don't think you get to pull that now.
Celeste, can you please just tell us what really happened? Please, just tell us.
Even when I'm put in check, it's just my nature not to give up. Because! Until the game's over, you never know what might happen!
Fine then. Let me settle it. Let me go over the case again, from the beginning, and shed light on all your crimes. And that'll bring everything to
end. Here comes my favorite part. Okay, let's see. It's a meeting with him. Putting Robo Justice together. So that would probably be the camera shot. Where is it? There we go. Let's see. Let's see what's since he was beaten with number 4. He was clobbered the first time with number 2. O'clock, okay.
Here's exactly what happened. Before anything, the killer persuaded someone to help carry out the murder. And that person was... Hifumi. With an accomplice, the killer was able to execute a number of otherwise impossible schemes. Convince someone to meet them in the rec room last night at 1 a.m. That someone they met with was Hiro. The murderous duo intended to pass Hiro off as the prime suspect. So when they met up with him, they drugged him, knocked him out, and stuffed him into the Robo Justice suit. Positioned himself to make it look like Robo Justice was attacking him, while the killer used a digital camera to take pictures of the assault. They did all this just to create evidence that would put the suspicion on Hiro. When they were done with him, they shoved him, still unconscious, into the pool room locker. And then finally, at 6 a.m., they moved into the murder phase of their plan.
Yeah, his bladder probably was a little stretched by the end of all that.
They called Taka to the equipment room. And that's where Hifumi killed him, making it the scene of the first murder. The murder weapon was Justice Hammer 4. Which was left there in the equipment room. The reason hammer number 4 was used was to create confusion about the order of the crimes. So, next they falsified 2 more assault incidents. For these attacks, the killers pretended to be the victims to solidify Robo Justice as the suspect. The first fake incident was the attack in the rec room. There, the killers wanted us to see Justice Hammer 1 and the Robo Justice pictures they'd taken. They wanted to make sure we bought the surprise attack story. The second fake incident was the attack in the library. This time, they planted Justice Hammer 2 and an injured Hifumi to sell us that story.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Ishimaru and his current state would have killed Hifumi. Which, I kinda wonder if that would have changed much in Celeste's plan. If you think about it. I kinda wonder if that would have really, if she would have just kind of, you know, started using Ishimaru to carry out her plan.
With these two incidents, the killers were able to create a certain preconception in our minds. That the suspect was increasing the size of the hammers and attacking people in order as they did. He fell right into their trap and started looking for the suspect based on that. But... while we did that, we left Hifumi alone in the nurse's office. This was exactly what Hifumi was hoping for. Took a blood packet from the refrigerator and Justice Hammer 3 and turned the room into a crime scene in which he himself had apparently been brutally murdered. He let out a scream to draw us back. And when we returned, that's what we found. Meanwhile, the other group that had been out searching found Taka's body at the same time.
Well, it's Ifumi.
So when we heard the body discovery announcement, we naturally assumed it was for Ifumi. We left the nurse's office. And Ifumi once again took advantage of the situation. He simply got up and made his escape. When we learned his body had disappeared, we all rushed back to the nurse's office. And once again, Ifumi had the chance he was waiting for. This time, he snuck into the equipment room.
See, there's probably fan art of Ifumi out there.
And use the dolly to move it all the way down to the repository. That explains how each of the bodies disappeared. But even Ifumi didn't know what the true killer had in mind for their final act.
So yeah, he was wiggling his hair.
Their plan all along was to kill Ifumi and get rid of the one person who could betray them. And they did it using an ordinary, everyday hammer from the repository. That should cover everything that happened in this case. And the villain behind it all is... Killer?
Yes, Flowers.
Listen to you, trying to take charge, as if you're my private instructor. I, Celestia Ludenberg. Actually, no. Taiko Yasuhiro is fine.
Taiko?
So, you finally accepted it.
I'm the kind of person... once I've lost, I don't like things to drag on.
Interesting.
Time for a story.
Okay, Monokuma. I'm ready to begin. Or... no. I suppose this is the end, isn't it?
It is indeed the moment we've all been waiting for. Time to vote, okay? Okay. If you would, please locate your lever and cast your vote. And when the votes are tallied, who will become the blackened?
I wonder.
Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one? What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be?
Yeah, you gambled a bit too high this time, I think.
I knew it.
Or coercion.
So then.
The thing they can't talk about in front of Monokuma.
Say what?
Just a second.
Sad Monokuma is happy me.
Indeed. I see.
Actually.
Are you okay with this? So then...
Damnation!
So yeah...
For me.
Oh,
As for me.
What?
This is just a tad bit uncomfortable. Abused. We will leave it off at abused. Because all she said was abused, and she let Hifumi's mind fill in the blanks for him. Oh yeah, that was a complete and total lie.
Completely unforgivable!
Most unfortunate. Actually,
what?
Indeed.
This is unforgivable. Completely unforgivable!
Honestly.
I swear I will save her!
Actually,
actually.
Yeah, he's not really a coward. When his back is against the wall, he will fight back. But that is pretty disgusting.
I see.
Indeed.
And this is just freaking cold.
Let's see.
That's just harsh.
Are you okay with this?
She doesn't care about making her death sad. It will become blatantly obvious in a minute.
So in the end...
What the heck? Well...
Don't be mean!
I wonder about that. Why? What the heck?
Yeah, the money was tempting, but that wasn't her main motivation. This whole time, she's been wanting to get out, despite all the let's work together and enjoy our comfortable life speech. She's been planning escape.
But...
You little bitch! This is fine. Honestly. As for me... Isn't it wonderful?
Yep. Her whole dream is to live in a European castle. With servants waiting on her hand and foot.
This is fine.
There is nothing to be done.
Got right to the edge, but didn't quite stick the landing. 10 million plus her winnings. She's won millions. But, you know, the 10 million would have pushed her over the top.
Just the worst. Oh. Do you understand? What is this? Yes, indeed. Isn't it wonderful?
Hey.
Monokuma's happy.
I guess I'll let Kyoko hold on to this. What? Will it really give you the hope you're looking for? I can't say I ever saw it that way. Which is why... Actually, it's not important. Well then, take care, everyone. Perhaps we'll meet again in another life.
And the trial is over. He ruined the mood, as he is wont to do. Awful. You think it's awful. You get to kill somebody. What are you complaining about?
Extreme! What are you gonna do?
Let me out of here!
Too bad.
What does he want? He's said it several times.
Hey! Hey!
Nanya?
Wawa?
So then...
What did you do, Monokuma?
Ooh. Hey.
Ooh, how exciting!
Sure you don't. I'm in agreement.
Well? See ya later!
So...
more than likely, it is a locker key. Yes.
Huh?
We at least get Alter Ego back.
Indeed. Hey.
What?
So...
come on. What?
Yes. Nagi.
Goodbye.
Well, then.
Yo!
No, not in the slightest.
Okay.
Shall we go? So then.
Yes, it has. It has been a while.
So.
Hey, that's cool. Still hiding things.
What?
Yeah, strangely enough, Nagi is not suspicious. He's worried. He's worried she's going to do something and get herself killed.
Indeed. What?
And showing a little faith is enough to really catch her off guard. And I'm pretty sure Taka is not in there yet, but probably could be. I mean, Alter Ego just pulled Mondo out of nowhere.
Correct.
Second floor, no surveillance camera monitor, and the storage closet has something interesting. Funny, I can kind of see a false wall there. Interesting.
Correct.
You must not leave. He's getting a little dizzy. Attacked by a luchador. And now everything is gone. More sound. Last time we got crazy sound, we end up with a laptop with a dead friend on it. So what do we find with these strange sounds this time? Sound effects, that's what we're finding. Sakura fighting Mono Bear here.
Why, you? What do you think you're doing? I asked you a question. What's the meaning of this? How dare you defy me? This wasn't part of the deal!
Deal?
I've made a decision. I will no longer retreat. No longer compromise. No longer regret. I've made my decision. I'm going to resist you.
Okay. But you do realize what will happen if you go through with this, right?
Very, very blasé with the okay there for hearing something like this.
You haven't forgotten, have you? What I'm holding hostage?
Mm-hmm. And then there were seven. Yep. It definitely looks that way. It definitely looks like she is the spy.